And first very very important thing, why it is called as FET? FET, you know, the expansion is field effect transistor, and it is called as FET because the current is controlled by field. What field? Electric field. How do you get electric field? How do you get electric field? Can anybody say how is electric field formed? How is electric field formed? Or what is the source of electric field? The electric field means creation of positive and negative charge, and line of charge, line the lines, electric lines of force will start from positive charge, they will end in negative charge. That is electric field, right? What creates an electric field? What creates an electric field? In PN junction diode, you say in reverse bias, a strong electric field is present across the diode. So what creates an electric field?
Charges, sir, opposite charges.
In other words, how do you create, how do you produce the opposite charges? You are going to give what? In reverse bias, what do you give as input to the PN junction diode? Voltage, right? So voltage is going to be the source for electric field. So if you are going to have a, if you are going to have see here, we are going to have two parallel plates. If I'm going to connect a battery, positive, negative, what will happen? The upper plate will have all the positive charge. The lower plate will have all the negative charge. The electric lines of force will be flowing in this direction from positive to negative. So if you want to create electric field, you have to supply voltage. So that is what they are saying here. See here, it is field effect transistor because current is controlled by electric field. How electric field is formed? Depending on what voltage I am going to give. Since current is controlled by voltage here, this FET is called as voltage controlled device, whereas BJT is called as current controlled device, because there one current depends on another current, but here one current depends on electric field. Electric field depends on voltage. So FET is a voltage controlled device, whereas BJT is a current controlled device. Major difference between the two transistors. So BJTs were very popular, and when FETs were invented, the popularity started shifting towards FET because FETs had lot of advantage compared to BJT. We will see at the end of this unit what all advantage a FET is going to have compared to BJT. Okay, and FET is a unipolar device. So BJT, can anybody expand BJT? What is BJT? What is BJT?
Bipolar transistor.
Yes, bipolar means, what did I say? What is the meaning of the word bipolar? What is the meaning of
Two
the word
polarities.
bipolar?
Two polarities.
Current is caused both by electrons and holes. Electrons may be majority carriers, holes may be minority carriers. Or electrons may be minority carriers, holes may be majority carriers. But so in BJT, I can write I is equal to I electron plus I hole. In general, okay, but in FET, I am going to have current conduction only by one polarity, only by majority carriers. So I can say minority carrier current is going to be zero. Okay, so FET is a unipolar device, whereas BJT is a bipolar device. Very, 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 very important difference. Okay, so FET is unipolar. So two differences we have seen so far with respect to BJT. First thing, BJT is current control, FET is voltage control. Second thing, BJT is bipolar device, FET is an unipolar device. Okay, two major differences we have seen. Why it is unipolar means depend on the construction. When I say explain about the construction and working, you will understand why FET is an unipolar device. And FET is classified into two. It is called as JFET and MOSFET. Okay, FET is a general term which indicates the family of field effect transistors. What all transistors working under the principle of electric field, those come under FET. So FET is broadly classified into two types. One is JFET. JFET is junction field effect transistor, and next one is MOSFET. MOSFET is metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Sometimes this MOSFET is called as IGFET or MOST. So all these are going to be the other names for MOSFET. So depending on the first, see, we are going to see about JFET and MOSFET in this chapter. The first we will focus on JFET. So I told you FET is a unipolar device. So definitely you will have unipolar, not definitely you will have an N-type version of FET and P-type version of FET. So FET, JFET is classified into two types, N-channel JFET and P-channel JFET. N-nu vandhale, you know, electrons are majority carriers. P-nu vandhale, you know, holes are going to be the majority carriers. And in N-channel JFET, I will not even be bothered to consider the effect of holes, because FET is a unipolar device. You can blindly ignore the effect of hole current, or I can assume the current due to holes is going to be zero. In P-channel JFET, since the holes are majority carriers, I can blindly say the current contributed by electron is going to be zero. This can be blindly assumed because we have stated that FET is a unipolar device. The construction of N-channel JFET, okay? And you know that whenever you have N and P channel, always we prefer N channel, because electrons and holes, when you compare, electrons are going to have a very high mobility. And the ore reason kada, even though you have two family of JFET, N channel and P channel JFET, we always prefer N channel JFET because electrons are going to be moving fast under the electric field. So they have a very high value of mobility. Okay. So, we give preference to N channel. We will not study about P channel, which means that the preference is only for N channel, because electrons are going to have a very high value of mobility under the influence of